Hi, FHS. Welcome to Lights Out Tonight. I'm Katie.
And I'm Chris.
And welcome back to our second digital episode.
We have a lot more awesome content in store for you guys.
So grab some popcorn and soda.
Drag your family out of their rooms.
And get comfy as you enjoy our show.
Lights Out Tonight.
Live from Farmington High School, it's Lights Out Tonight with Charlotte Anderson, Chris Antwi, Sam Baldwin, Katie Baum, Kinley Collier, Tyler DeWard, Michaela Gorman, Caitlin Kincaid, Tyler Rosenberg, Megan Self, Brighton Sheehan, Andy Stinson, Mackenzie Swanson, Julia Werner, Morgan Wiebold, Isaac Weber, Mr. Mathis, Mr. Tauchi, ladies and gentlemen, Katie Baum and Chris Antwi.
Over time, there have been many crimes that have been committed where the police haven't found the right suspect, and nobody gets blamed for the crime. This week, we have the first episode of Mysteries in History, where we will dig deep into crimes that haven't been solved.
Welcome to the first episode of Mysteries in History. I'm Sam Baldwin, and throughout this series, I'm going to go over events that have happened in the past that don't really have an answer to. Today, we're going to be talking about the Axeman of New Orleans. The Axeman struck from May 1918 through October of 1919. Throughout all of his attacks, he killed 6 total people and attacked 12. The first victims of the Axeman killings was Catherine and Joseph Maggio. They were both cut by razor blade and struck with an axe. The Axeman would always attack when the victims were sleeping because that's when they were most vulnerable. To enter the home, the Axeman would cut a panel on the wood door and enter through there. The Axeman never used his own weapons. He would always use weapons he found at the home. Like, the main suspect was one of Joseph's brothers because the razor blade came from his barbershop that he owned. A lot of people in New Orleans were scared out of their minds, but the men in the households had an idea. They would stay up at night with a shotgun, so if the Axeman came, they were ready. March 15th was a strange day for New Orleans when the Axeman sent a letter in to the Times-Picayune, a newspaper for New Orleans. In the letter, he stated that he would be in New Orleans on March 19th, 1919. He said that anyone on Tuesday night listening to jazz music at 12:15 would be spared, and anyone who was not would feel the wrath of the Axeman. Luckily, on the night of the 19th, nobody was killed or attacked by the Axeman. The last attack happened on October 27th, 1919, when the Axeman struck Esther and Mike Pepitone. Over time, there have been many theories about who the axe killer was. One theory is that it's a bunch of different killers, like a copycat killer. The other theory that it was Joseph Mumfrey. Later on in history, Joseph came up to Esther and said that he would kill her the same way he killed her husband. Before the police could gather enough evidence to bring Joseph in, Esther shot him 2 times in the head. So who was the Axeman killer? Was it Joseph Mumfrey? Was it a bunch of different copycats? Until next time, thank you for watching this week of Mysteries in History.
Morgan Weeble now joins us for the very first time with Morgan's Marvelous Moments. Take it away, Morgan.
Hello, welcome to Morgan's Marvelous Moments. I'm your host, Morgan, and today we are in my kitchen because we are making instant coffee. I know you've seen it on TikTok and everywhere else, so today we're going to be making that. I don't have instant coffee, and that's one of the main ingredients, so I have to make my own coffee and then whip it. All right. Now that our coffee is done brewing, we are going to put 2 tablespoons of that into a bowl, measure it out. A little, one, two, there we go. Maybe a little extra just for a little. We're going to take this and pour it into our mixer, like so. And then we are going to pour in our 2 tablespoons of sugar. And then we are gonna mix that all together. All right, after hand mixing it and mixing it with my mixer, KitchenAid, we got to something fluffy, right? That kind of looks right. So now we are going to get our glass filled with ice, and then we're gonna pour some milk in there. A little 1-2. So now we are going to pour the liquid fluffy stuff into our, anyway. So we're just gonna give that a little stir. Maybe we should add a little cinnamon, all right? A little something, something, oh. It's not bad. It's actually not bad. You know, you can't taste the coffee. It kind of just tastes like milk to me. But you know, I give this an A for effort. So try it at home. All right, gang, that is all for Morgan's Marvelous Moments. I'll see you guys next week.
In an attempt to spice it up while at home, Tyler Rosenberg is sampling a variety of food combos. Here's a taste of that.
Welcome to Tyler Tastes It. I'm Tyler Rosenberg, and today we have one of Elvis Presley's favorite snacks. It's a grilled peanut butter banana bacon sandwich. To prepare it, we had to put bread, we had to smother peanut butter on both sides, on both slices, and we put banana slices and bacon, and then to grill it, we grilled it in bacon grease from So, Elvis, don't leave me now. It's not a bad consistency, I'd say. There's a lot of peanut butter. Most of the chewiness just coming from the bananas, really. I mean, I can taste the bacon. And the bananas, too, as the aftertaste. But, you know, it's not as bad as I originally thought. Not as bad. If you have any suggestions for the next food, then comment in the section below or tell someone, really. Thank you for watching. This is me, Tyler, signing off.
On the last episode of Moving with Mathis, we explored the simple but creative ways to keep yourself in shape in your front yard. Today, we join Mr. Mathis to find ways we can stay active while inside the house. Stay tuned and stay active.
But we got to do a quick warm-up and stretching routine. So first of all, I'm going to stretch out the arms. We're going to take this arm, put it over the top of our head, grab the elbow, and stretch. And do that for about 5 to 10 seconds. We're going to do it with the other arm. Grab the elbow as best you can. Pull and lean. I lean a little bit to the right just to get a good stretch along the left side. Feels really good. Right arm pulling across. Grab my left arm, lock it off like so, and hold. Pull it across, lock it off with the right arm. 10 seconds. The arms, the hands and wrists, especially for what we're gonna do next. So I take and start rolling the wrists. 1, 2. Stop, go the other way. Let's go 10 the other way. I'm going to do what's called lunges, and very, very simple. I'll just put my left foot that way, and my right foot will be perpendicular, kind of as a back. And I'll just lean in to that left leg, and I'm just going to lean in, being careful not to go too far over the top of my left foot. I'll just hold that for 10. Let's go the other way. All right, kids, remember when we did the lunges to loosen up your legs? Well, that takes us to the very next exercise, which is vacuuming. So here's what I want you to remember with vacuuming. You want to get your body positioned behind the vacuum and legs and the knees bent. You're just going to hit the power button. Then you're going to go back and forth. Back and forth. Make sure you get behind it. Make sure you're controlling the cable. And look at, I'm leaning into it. It's a great workout for the legs and the arms and the shoulders. That just about does it from here. That's all I've got for you. But remember, some simple things you can do around a house can keep you in shape. Be well, stay safe. We'll see you soon.
The BIG broadcast has been MIA for a couple of weeks, but today we're back with another spectacular episode. Enjoy this week's blurb on the art of mixing and mastering.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of the BIG broadcast. I'm your host, the BIG Caesar, as well as my other co-hosts, Isaac and Megan. Can you guys say hi?
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Hi, everyone.
For this episode, I've always been asked, like, oh, how do you make music? What's your equipment? What kind of stuff do you use? How do you make yourself sound so professional? Well, one, I personally don't think that I sound professional whatsoever, but I, you know, work with all the time. So hopefully I'm just going to go through with you guys and the rest of the audience what my process is like. So I'm going to show you guys a song I made called Clementine. I ain't really here before.
So I get it right. Yeah, I don't need no friends. All I wanna get is Gucci lenses. She put me in a trance with her little dances. I think I just got myself a chance here. With all these bands, I'm like, nah, nah. I call her Clementine, and she'll be my Valentine. Would you walk up in my ride? Clementine, would you tell her lullaby? Little baby, don't be shy. Shorty, I pop up in my ride.
Okay, so like what edits or effects
are being placed?
Add to those to that section.
Right now I have Paramedic EQ2, a Fruity compressor, transient processor, a pitcher, reverb, and a Fruity delay band. You can see how muffled and muddy that muddy like my vocals are. So, and that kind of like makes it more, I guess, obviously more clear and less muffled and muddy. Basically, you don't want to make it sound splat. Like, you don't want your dB level.
Splat.
Yeah.
You want it tight.
Exactly. And if it goes over it, it's not like your song is, like, ruined, but, like, you won't get, you know, what you like. So, one of my favorite parts is adding this thing called pitcher. And a lot of people get it confused. In a sense, mm-hmm. It technically is, but what I like about it is that it can make me sound like a singer. Instead of being incredibly robotic, it takes like the pitches where I sing off key and just brings them.
Yeah.
And basically perfects my vocals for me. Like if you put it in a certain preset, it won't work for every song. You have to like really like dibble and dabble with a lot of things. And if you have it in fast, that's what makes it more robotic and auto-tune like. If you have it in medium, that's particularly your own voice.
Okay. Thank you for watching episode 2 of the BIG broadcast season 3. Remember to stay positive,
stay groovy,
and stay as smooth as a smoothie. We'll see you guys next week.
Peace.
Congratulations to Miss Meyer and her husband on the birth of Beckett Dean Meyer. Baby Meyer was born on Friday, April 3rd, weighing 7 pounds, 11 ounces, and 20 and 3/4 inches long. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Meyer.
10th and 11th grade students, interested in joining Link Crew for next year? Please watch the informational video that Mr. Pickens sent out on Schoology this week. Applications are available on Schoology and are due on Friday, April 24th by 3:15 p.m. Join the Schoology course to get more information. All 10th and 11th grade students are welcome to apply.
Seniors, during this time of separation from your friends at the high school, we hope that you are doing well, staying connected with your family, and taking the time to appreciate all the things we have in life. We have to believe that life will return to normal someday soon.
Around this time each year, Ms. Dimmich and Mr. Onzorg are busy preparing their students for the annual cabaret performance. This is the performance where FHS choir students get the chance to perform songs from jazz to musical theater. As students have been preparing their auditions online, they also have been creating their own music. This week, Kylie Snowbeck performed a song called Reckless Love for all of you. Enjoy!
Nowadays, staying in touch with everything that we knew from the high school is pretty difficult. But this week, Mrs. Pierce brings us the admin minute to update all of us on one of our favorite can-do canine training dogs, Zion.
Due to COVID-19 and all of the closures across the state of Minnesota, CanDo Canines has also had to close. We haven't been able to go to our weekly classes, so we continue our learning at home and in the backyard. Some of the basic skills that we continue to practice and master are sit, down, and settle. Settle is a good skill for all dogs to have, especially when they need to be examined by a veterinarian. Zion and I continue to work on two additional skills, park and under. Under is when the dog will go under a chair head first, and park is when he will maneuver his body so that his rear end goes under the chair first. As you'll see, Zion is very proud of his parking skills. He wants you too to know, with lots of practice, your parallel parking skills will be as good as his. Here we are practicing two commands, heel and side. By doing this, he moves from one side to the other, pivoting around my body while I sit in a chair. If I had a wheelchair at home, we would practice it around the wheelchair just in case he ever is deemed a mobility assist dog. Here, Zion and I continue to work on our pivots. This is an important skill for him to be able to master should he ever need to be with an individual that is in a wheelchair or utilizing a walker. Time to take our training outside and enjoy the beautiful Minnesota spring weather. I think Zion is done with distance learning as well. He is really looking forward to the day of going back to school and being a certified can-do canine.
Thanks for joining us on Lights Out Tonight.
We are excited that we get to still create and show all of our hard work to you guys.
So even though everything right now isn't normal, it's important to try to find things that make you happy.
We hope our show brought some variety to your day and smiles to your faces.
So that's all we have for this episode. I'm Katie.
I'm Chris.
See you next week.
See you next week.